snack time.
We've just walked in, we're at the Village Hotel, Leeds South, and we've just had a free room upgrade.
So crunchy, these are going to be amazing.
I'm about to try some vegan Yorkshire puds. Look at my sister's lovely Christmas tree. So Jane, I think this has to be one of your best trees ever.
It'd be nice when the train set's done underneath.
Oh, is it not done yet?
No, we've got to water the tree and then put it out.
Looks really, it's a really lovely shape. I like that. You've got some really lovely, oh, you've got a new mirror.
Yes.
But that wall's not staying that colour.
Oh.
It's changing.
I need to do all the rest of my deckies as well. It looks very nice everywhere.
Thank you. We haven't finished the lights and that outside the house. That's going to be Sunday. Charlie, do you want a cup of tea?
And Molly's dressed as a reindeer.
Yeah, Poppy's got two outfits to choose.
Poppy, you've got to go and choose your outfit.
Yeah, you did.
Poppy, which one did she choose?
She did sniff Santa.
She sniffed Santa?
Yeah.
Oh, Poppy, you want to dress up as Santa? Santa paws. Pops, do you want to be Santa Paws? I think she does. Just wanted to clarify, by the way, that we have actually been testing this week. We haven't been around anyone this week. We've been testing all week. We've tested this morning, and all our friends that we're meeting up with later on today, everyone has tested, and we've all been showing our tests together. And my sister tested before we went to her house today as well, so we've been super, super careful, haven't we?
Yeah, doing everything we can.
Yeah, and we're looking forward to a little escape this afternoon. Just driven past the most beautiful manor. We're just driving through, there's a delay on the M40, so we're driving through the little villages, and I was telling Aid that because I used to live in Oxford, I grew up in Oxford, to my grandparents, the big main roads weren't there then, so we used to drive through all these little villages to go and visit my nan, but they're real like sort of like stony sort of Cotswoldy little villages, so I'll see if I can get, oh, that one's got a little pond, see if I could capture some on the drive through for you. And on the other side we are driving past an RAF base, Weston-on-the-Green. It is very, very small, isn't it? We're stopping at the services. It's really nice little services here, and we've just been to Greg's. We've got a bag of Marks and Spencer's goodies and Greg's goodies. It's really, really cold. So this is Cherwell Services where we've stopped. It's actually quite nice in there, isn't there? They've got quite a nice selection.
One thing on your door, please.
Oh, thank you.
Thanks.
I thought I'd just show you our snacky time. So you'd already bought your Tesco's meal deal, hadn't
yep,
you? Yep. Aidable Tesco meal deal with squares.
Yep.
Salt and vinegar squares.
Yeah.
I've just picked up my favourite Greg's tandoori chicken baguette. Love these. And we've also got from Mark's, we love these lemon and sultana danishes. We might actually have these tomorrow morning. We haven't decided, but they're going to be for the room. We've got sausage rolls as well. You've also got a pack for the room. Yeah. Aid's just picked up some salt and vinegar twirls.
Maybe tonight.
We've got so many treats. And these Danish boobies from Greg's. Very nice. Oh, and we picked up some stocking fillers in M&S as well. Is it lunchtime?
Are we going to eat?
Yeah, I'm really hungry. Let's just hope nobody's going. Oh, we're going over a little canal. I just realised that. Whee! road to the top and you can't see.
Literally couldn't see.
Yeah. Just driving past East Midlands Airport. There's a big Amazon warehouse there. This is all new territory for us, isn't it? Can't see the airport actually. But I could see it on Google Maps. DHL. Well, it's very cargo-esque here.
There's a freight.
And we've got these things over here as well.
Power station.
Is that a power station?
Yeah.
But we haven't seen any peas and the signs for Alton Towers. We've just walked in, we're at the Village Hotel, Leeds South. And we just had a free room upgrade. We walked in, the lady was lovely. It's self-check-in, but somebody's there to take you through each step. She was so lovely, really chatty, and Aid explained that we have a village in Farnborough near where we live and that we've been there. She was asking us if we'd been to other ones, if we stayed. We checked in, I just booked a standard double room. And she looked at it, she said, oh, that room's not very big. She said, let me give you a nicer room. And she's given us a really lovely free room upgrade.
Yeah.
We just arrived, pull up the blind, and we saw our friends Leigh and Nick coming up the walkway here. And this is our lovely room. We've got a quite cool little light there and red seat. Got this lovely big window. So there's no naked jumping out of bed in the morning, Aid.
Oh, no.
I know, you're going to have to refrain. Nice TV there. Got this huge, great big bed. Lots of mirrors everywhere. I always complain about not having full-length mirrors. We've got a good, decent amount of mirrors. Aid spotted tea and coffee making facilities.
Nice mugs
as well. Better than a tiny little poxy white mug. And more mirrors and big, decent. Oh, what are these? Full-length mirrors. They're really weird.
No,
oh, yeah. I thought it was a great big safe for a moment. You can just about see through to the bathroom through here.
Well, it's kind of, just a...
Oh, but it's frosted
the
as well.
On, so
ah,
off. You've got,
that's quite cool. We haven't stayed in a village for years, have we?
No. A bathroom?
Oh, we can have a bath later. And it's a decent size. I think we're both fit in
nice,
that
actually.
One. Yay, big over-the-top shower. Has it got shower gel and stuff?
There's hand wash stuff there. Oh, there is, look, sort of...
Oh, yeah, I didn't see it before, and it's called Upper Deck. Is that, do you think, the nicer rooms then?
Yeah, well, I saw they started when we turned left. So
sink worked about
is that
the towels.
Where is that the... like when you're in the aeroplane, you turn left?
Oh, the towels are nice. That beats the Disney towels we've just had. They're not super thick, but they're soft.
How many towels are there?
Is there just one big towel?
There's just one.
Are we sharing a towel?
We need to ask for something.
Oh, maybe I'm supposed to use the hand towel because I'm little. Don't know. Is it definitely one?
Yeah.
Hmm. We've been down to the bar and we've had drinks and we've bought Prosecco from home. Aid borrowed a couple of glasses from the bar and we're going to get ready for the evening. Having Prosecco, aren't we? And sausage rolls.
Yeah.
We know how to party. You're having a lovely time.
Yeah, it's lovely. I'm going to put this one in the cool bag.
Okay. Just having a little picnic in the room. Prosecco crisps and sausage rolls. The village are organising something really, really nice. Apparently, socks are the most requested things by all homeless charities. So the village are having... They're on a mission. By the way, my camera's facing me, so you're fine.
No,
but there's mirrors,
don't you think?
No, not this
one. No, I just wanted to...
Okay. The Village Hotel chain are on a mission to collect at least 10,000 socks for the homeless this year. So we went on to Amazon. I've picked up 12 thermal pairs of socks. They're only a tenner, and we're going to go and drop them off downstairs. They've got like a big collection point. So if you've got a Village Hotel near you, try and drop in some socks if you can. You can pick them up so cheap online or from Primark. And I just think if it really helps somebody out, that's such a nice thing to do. We're also big, big supporters of Crisis, the homeless charity. We haven't given Christmas cards for years and years now. We just give to Crisis every year. The nice thing is with Crisis, this... The current price for one person is £29.06. And we do it every year. We pay for a couple of people to have not only a Christmas dinner, anywhere that's, it's not just Christmas Day, it's the whole collection of different times, but they get support for the whole year round. There's haircuts, there's dentists, there's appointments with doctors, there's sessions with people to try and get you housing, just to get you back on your feet. This £29.06 does so much for one person. So I will leave the link below if anybody else wants to go and take a look. It's a charity that we feel really passionate about. As you know, if you watch our channel, we are proper home people. We love being at home, we love our coziness, and it's just something that we feel so sad about this time of year. So if you're interested, go and take a look.
Didn't film when we went away. I had every intention of filming a little bit. I did get my phone out a couple of times and film, but I didn't. We just had such a lovely time. And like when we were out in the evening, I just didn't want to take my camera around with me, to be really honest. And I didn't even really take any photos. How bad is that? I just had such a lovely time. We laughed so much. We've had the best time. I'm sure Leigh and Nick, our friends, have vlogged it, so I'll leave a link to them if you want to go and check it out. But we had lots and lots of fun. We drove back yesterday. We were so tired. I had such a bad night's sleep in the hotel. I just woke up so warm, and so we had a very long drive back yesterday. It took us in the end about 5.5 hours, 6 hours, something like that, with stops and that. So we got organized last night and had a really early night, walked the dog, had a nice bath, unpacked, put the washing on, and it's Sunday morning and we are back to work. So I am about to work on kits. I also want to make a midweek roast today, and I'm thinking of prepping a load of stuff ready for Christmas Day as well to make it a little bit easier. So I might do that too. I'm taking a break from work and, excuse the washing machine, I'm about to try some vegan Yorkshire Puds. All it is self-raising flour, baking powder, salt, milk, vegetable oil for the greasing. How easy can that be? So if they go well today, I will then freeze them, and I've got them for Christmas Day. I've also made cheesy leeks already, just leeks in a cheese sauce. This one I'm going to freeze, ready for Christmas Day. And all I need to do is take it out, defrost it, add cheese on the top and bung in the oven. They're not cooked all the way through, so they're ready to be cooked. Then I've got these for us today. I have cooked up some Brussels, and I'm going to be frying those later with onion. And I'm going to use some fig chutney on those as well to see how they are. And again, if we like them, I'm going to freeze these for Christmas Day. So I'm mixing the batter, and it is just like a pancake batter really, isn't it? When you think about it, I'm using oat milk. And I'll leave the recipe that I'm trying down below, just in case anybody else wants to try it, because it's not all just about vegans. It could be that if you know somebody that's got an egg intolerance. I'm going to make mine quite thick. I've used, instead of 2 cups of milk, I've actually done 1.5. I wanted to make sure it was nice and thick. And the secret to a good roast potato is to have your potatoes nice and dry. They're drained off, giving them a good shake in the pan. So as you can see, they've got all the fluffy bits. And now I'm going to do something really fun. I've got my little flour shaker, and we're going to coat them in flour, but you want them to be nice and dry, so make sure that they've really dried out. I always pop them back in the pan and then pop the pan back on for a bit so that it dries off any water. And I've got the tray in the oven on really high at the moment as well, with the oil. I'm using vegetable oil. The oil is sizzling. I'm going to just turn them around so that they're all coated in the oil. They're really hot. And I have to confess, I keep forgetting that there's only 2 of us. And I got a bit carried away with potatoes and then realised that I was making loads. And I always add onion in with mine as well. There we go. Sprinkle of salt. And the oven is on 210. And I'll set the timer for 30 minutes. And then I'll give them a check. I'll probably end up cooking them for about an hour though. So the oil is nice and hot, and what you want is that sizzle. Yes, that's exactly what you want for a good Yorkshire pudding. I'm going to pop them in the oven for about 15 minutes on 210. We'll see how they do. I'm going to roast off some carrots and parsnips as well. I just washed them. I leave all the skins on, cut them up, little bit of oil, and I've spread over some clear honey as well. I'm not actually too not impressed with those. That didn't make sense. I'm actually quite impressed with those. I didn't actually fill them up too much because I didn't want them just to go everywhere. So I think next time I would put more batter in, but they actually look all right. I'll do a taste test later. One thing I would say about these Yorkshires, we haven't tried them yet, but they feel a lot stodgier than regular ones. But for an alternative, I think they will be just fine. Next thing I'm gonna make with you is gravy. I get a lot of people that ask how I make my gravy, so I'm going to show you right now. It's really easy and really tasty and so much better than using just Bisto. If you can use your veggie water, use that. I've just done cabbage in this and taken it out, and I've got the water in there. It's nice and hot. And to that, I'm going to add chicken gravy granules, Bisto, the gravy ones, the beef ones. They are both veggie though, but you can check, most of them are. I'm going to be using some, I've got Prosecco open that needs using up, but just, you can use regular wine. Obviously, if you don't drink, you don't have to add wine. The secret ingredient is the red currant jelly. Makes all the difference, a good dollop of that. If I run out of this though, I do use cranberry sauce, a little bit of mustard, and if you've got commons, mustard powder, you can add that as well, and seasoning. The pan is on, and the key to a good gravy is lots of whisking. I'm gonna add a load of the beefy ones, a load of the chicken ones. I like the mix of the both. And I'm gonna whisk that up. I like my gravy to be nice and thick. I do not like a thin, watery, flavorless gravy. And then like now, it's got a little bit too thick. Let's add some Prosecco in. As you know, I'm not one to measure things. I just kind of do it. Just go by sight and test. And then if it's still too thin, I'll add a little bit more water, which I think I will here. Oh, got a little bit in the kettle. It's just cold water from the kettle I'm adding. And the only reason it looks frothy on top is because I'm using Prosecco and not wine, but it will end up tasting the same. I am going to add a decent amount of red currant jelly. I will probably even add more than that. About a teaspoon of French mustard. And a little mustard powder. Always put this in the lid or on a teaspoon. Never just sprinkle it. The amount of times I would do something like that, and it all comes down too fast. And now give this a really good whisk. Just tasted it, it definitely needs some salt. Give that a good mix. And I'll just keep adding to it until I'm happy with it. But the thickness is lovely, it's a really thick gravy. That's done, I'm not even gonna add any more seasoning to it. I'm really happy with it now. It's thick, it's winey, you can just about taste the red currant jelly. It's just really, really perfect. I'm just doing my Brussels now. These were the ones that I parboiled earlier on. And these are for Christmas Day as well. And I've got them in a pan, it's a non-stick pan, but I haven't added anything to it. No oil, no seasoning. And I kind of want them to burn a little bit like you would with Bub and Squeak, and I just keep bashing them up. I did slice them up as well so that they're in little pieces. How do you like your Brussels sprouts? Let me know what you do with yours. So once cooled down, ready for the freezer, I've got my cheesy leeks for Christmas Day. And because I can use these in the freezer, all I need to do is take it out, pop cheese on the top, put it in the oven, and I've got my Brussels sprouts as well. The last thing to the Brussels sprouts I have added, to the Brussels sprouts, I'm adding this fig chutney. It's fig with shallot. It's amazing with cheese and biscuits, and I think it will be amazing with the Brussels. I've left the pan off, but it's still nice and hot, and I've just added a good dollop. If you wanted to do bacon as well, cook the bacon in the pan first so it's nice and crispy, and then add that afterwards. I think these are going to be so tasty. So we have very, very crispy roast potatoes. It's important not to move them whilst they're roasting. I'm just lifting these up. You can see they are so crunchy. These are going to be amazing. Cheesy leeks, honeyed parsnip and carrots. I've got some cabbage over there as well. Anyone else think a roast dinner is the best meal? And
and I can't understand people that don't like gravy with their roast. I've just done a grilled chicken breast, by the way. I'm just doing like a midweek roast dinner. Nice and easy. And I've got part of Christmas Day already done. How easy is that? Does that look good? What do you reckon, Aid? You looking forward to this?
Very nice.
Right, just after 8, and we've just cracked open all of this from our cheesy advent. We've got so much catching up to do. And we're going to watch a movie, we're going to watch Deck the Halls in front of the tree and eat cheese and biscuits.
Good morning! I'm starting Monday morning off with some deep cleaning. Oh, I'm just going through the freezer. Anyone else feel like they have to really clean everything before Christmas? We want to make space for some Christmas food in the freezer. Obviously, like yesterday, I started cooking. And I've got stuff in my freezer that has been in there for so long. Things like potato waffles that the kids decided they no longer liked. And I've got a big box of them. We don't eat them, and they're now probably a couple of years old. So I've got stuff in there that's really old that shouldn't be in there. And so I'm just going through, I'm emptying everything and deep cleaning each shelf.
Rubbish bag, food. I was gonna put all the meat and fish in here, but actually I think it might be fish and veggie in here. We've just got the meat in here. We'd had a lolly spillage down here. I've just binned loads of ice lollies as well because they'd gone really, you know when they go really icy, but they'd kind of leaked as well. So I've cleaned all that. I also got and stood on the table and cleaned all the top there as well because it was all cobwebby. I do need to get some cleaning up done up there as well because I've got loads of cobwebs there too. But I'm just taking each shelf out and giving it a really, really good wash.
I also meant to say, the roast potatoes last night, yesterday afternoon, were the best roast potatoes I think I've ever made. I think it's all down to my new roasting trays, my oven trays. I've just washed this up. As you can see, it comes up so well. It washes up really, really well. And I haven't been using these for things like roast potatoes. I've been using my old trays because I didn't want to ruin the new ones because they were quite pricey, even though I got them on Amazon Warehouse. They're decent ones and I knew to replace them. They cost a lot of money. But I'm always going to use these from now on. Do you find with your roast potatoes, when you try and take them out, the bottoms often stick? They didn't with these. They just lifted off and that made the potato so, so crispy. They were the crispiest but gooeyest in the middle potatoes I've ever made. Sorry, the thing is going on the freezer. I need to shut the freezer door. I think a good roast potato has a lot to do with your oven tray.
Right, I think this is a little bit better. We've got pies, ice cream, vegan stuff on the top. Aid's vodka, is that vodka in there?
Yes.
Defrosting the beef. This is the shelf we want to be empty for Christmas stuff. Defrosting the beef tomorrow for a goulash. I've got berries in there, Christmas food. This one is a bready one. I think I need to run this down. I've got loads of wraps, pastry. Oh, I've got vegan pies there. They could go up. Bread just for toasting, corn mince. And then I've got naan breads and panini rolls. In here is your veggies. I've got, well, I don't really freeze veg apart from peas, but I've got like hash browns. I've got some fries for the kids. I think that's it actually in there. Yeah, that is it. That's a little bit emptier. This one is a meat one. We've got bacon, we've got mince, burgers, and loads and loads of chicken breasts and some nuggets for Louis. Got seafood. Fish, corn pieces, calamari, corn sausages, hot dogs, and parsley. And that is it. A nice clean freezer. Doggy, out you get.
Poppy.
I'm going to finish this video now. I ended up working yesterday till really, really late to get my kits out. So I didn't end up filming much yesterday, but the kits have gone. And I plan to get some good organisation hopefully going in the house this week, some good cleaning, and I want to get organised ready for Christmas. So hopefully, fingers crossed, I will do that and share that with you next week. Thank you for watching. Let me know if you've started doing your deep cleaning before Christmas, what you're up to. Are you organising as well, or do you just not bother?
let me know. Speak to you later. Take care. Bye.